and the subscribe button. And you should subscribe to this channel.
What did I say about singing?
Oh yeah, I forgot. Subscribe.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman, I'm a game developer, and today we are going to create a turn-based RPG battle system. Right, so let me show you the demo. Now, a couple of days ago, I posted a similar tutorial. Walk around this village. I found this sprite on the internet. Whoa, and we found a battle. Okay, so let's battle this chicken. I mean Pidgey. Okay. Now, for this example, I only made two choices, fight or run. So let's hit fight. Okay, the chicken fights back. We fight again. Fight again. Now, the damage is done randomly. We don't have critical damage yet, but that will be pretty easy to add after. Let's hit the chicken again. And notice that the damage is set to a random range. Okay, which means that Pikachu can inflict certain range of damage, same as the chicken. I mean Pidgey. Fight! And I think we won. Yeah. If you walk around again, whoa, you can find another Pidgey to fight. So let's fight him. He fights back. Okay, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to create commercial games. Okay, so let's go over the assets. If you click on your main character, you can see that he is a 8-direction object. If you run the frame, you notice that he can move in 8 directions. Now, if you're not sure how to do the scrolling, check out the previous video. If you go around here, you notice that you cannot get into battles. Now, if you double click on the background, you can see that this is just a picture. We have these red objects everywhere, which are going to be the battles. You can place these battles randomly, or you can place them whatever you want. Now, if you enable layer 2, see that this is where our battles happen. This area doesn't scroll. So if you double click on it, you can see that this is just a picture. Here is Pikachu. Pikachu is a path object. This is the path he follows. If he went on the runtime, you can see that we are not creating him at start. Same as Pidgey or the enemy. You can replace this image for whatever you want. He's also not being created at start. If you enable the third layer, you can see that we have our GUI or graphic user interface. Some people just call it HUD's, heads up display. Here is Pikachu's health. It's a counter. I set it to be a horizontal bar. Same as the enemy's health. It's also a horizontal bar. Initial value 100. Initial value 100. But you can change this. Those are just pictures for the backgrounds. Same as Pikachu. This here too is a picture. But I have placed invisible objects on top of it. I have this spawn point. So we can spawn Pikachu and the chicken. I mean Pidgey. And layer number 4 is for our counters. We have a layers counter. This is the icon I'm using for this. We have a fight counter. I made this one red. We have a turn counter. This is the icon for it. We have a timer counter. This is the icon I made for this. And finally, I made a delay counter. And here is the icon I'm using for this. Now, all these counters are the same thing. They're counters. Okay, so let's hide these layers. And if you run this, you'll notice that you can see your counters. Now, you don't have to use counters, you can use variables if you wanted to. I like to use counters because it's easy to debug. And really, it makes no difference. Alright, so let's get started. Notice that these layers have names. This layer is called Battle. This layer here is called GUI. And this layer here, we don't actually need it, but we can delete it later. Go to the event editor, and you can see that at the start of the frame, I'm hiding these layers. Let me delete that. And if you run this, you'll notice that the first thing that shows up is the battle layer. Let's hide that. We're gonna hide that using a counter. Here's the counter we're gonna be using for that. The layer counter. So if that counter is set to 0, we're going to hide the battle and the heads up display. So under the layers object, go to layers, select by name, visibility, hide. And we are going to hide battle. We'll click on this, copy the same action, and I'm going to edit it. And we're going to hide GUI. Graphic user interface, or you can call it whatever you want. Let's create a new condition. If our character collides with one of the battle objects, we're going to set this counter to 1. And we are going to destroy the battle object. So let's copy line 6. If the counter is set to 1, it's gonna be the opposite. Going to 2 layers, my name, visibility, and I'm going to select show. We're going to show battle. Double click on it, copy the action, and we're going to show GUI. We're also going to ignore the control, player controller, ignore control. And when the counter is 0, we're going to restore the control. We're gonna make the battles visible at start. So when our character collides with one of the battles, we're gonna set the layers counter to 1. Throw it out, touch the battle, and you can see that that works. So under line 7, let's create a Pikachu. Okay, so we can't see our object. Let's enable that. From this object, and it's gonna be somewhere around here. Let's try it out. Oops. And that sort of works. We're gonna make this event run only once when it loops. Okay, so let's try it out. Here's the battle. Maybe he needs to move back a little more. Try it again. That looks not too bad. Let's create the enemy. From this point. Try it out. Touch the enemy. And there is our enemy. I'm going to enable this layer. And you can see that we have 2 buttons here. Here is our fight button and our run button. Let's make a new group. Call it battle. So if the user clicks on an object, the fight button, then under the health bar for the enemy, we're going to subtract random range from 20 to 27. Try it out. Find a battle. Press the fight button. That works fine, but we want this to work only when we are inside of a battle. So our layers counter needs to be set to 1. Now to change turns, we're using this counter, the turn counter. We're gonna set this at 1. And this counter needs to be 0 for this to work. Okay, so once we click on it, we can't click on it again. Try it out. Here it is. Counter is equal 0 now. We can attack, fight, and now I cannot click on it again because it's the enemy's turn. Now when the turn counter is set to 1, we're gonna add 1 to the timer. Now when the timer is 120, then we'll reset the timer back to 0. We're also going to reset the turn counter, so it's our turn again. But we're going to damage to the player. Under Pikachu's health, let's subtract random range from 15 to 20. You can change this depending how strong your enemy is. Try it out. Let's run into a battle. Here is the battle. Fight. You can notice that Pikachu's health went down. Fight again. Pikachu's health went down as well. We are pretty even here. But I think we're winning now. And Pikachu won this battle. So once the enemy has no health, we need to destroy him. If the enemy's health is equal 0, then we destroy the enemy. Now if you click on the enemy, on their fade outs, I'm using zoom, okay? You can change this to whatever you want. There's like 1.5 million dissolve or fade out your character without having to use animation. I'm using a zoom. So let's try it out. Fight the chicken. I mean, Pidgey. Fight again. 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 And this time he was not even close. Whoa, this is still working, so we need to disable that. This counter is only going to work if the number of enemies is greater than zero. So that way, when he's dead, he cannot kill you anymore. Let's try it out. Let's battle PG. And the last one. And he dies. Now, if you double click on Pikachu, you can see that he has a hit animation. He also has a damage animation. Let's call the animations every time they get damaged. So when this counter reaches 120, under the same line, we're going to change Pikachu's animation, change animation sequence to hit. And you can see that this time, you can see a damage animation. Let's do the same thing for the enemy. There's the enemy under line 10. Under animation, change animation sequence to hit. Try it out. Let's hit the fight button. That works fine. Now we need a way to get out of the battle. Under line 13, when the enemy's health is zero, we are going to add one to the delay counter. When our delay counter is greater than 150, greater or equal, then we reset all the counters. We set this counter back to zero. Our timer back to zero, turn back to zero, fight back to zero, and our layers counter back to zero. We're gonna add some health to Pikachu, maybe random range, 20 to maybe 40. We're also going to set the enemy's health back to 100 for the next battle. Let's make the battles invisible at start. Try it out. There's a battle. Let's fight. Hit us back. Hit him back again. Okay, we're pretty even now. Fight again. Whoa, this is pretty close. Whoa, this is really close. Fight. Fight again. And he's out. And we go back to the map. See if we can find another battle. Whoa, we found another battle, but Pikachu was already there, so we forgot to destroy Pikachu. Okay, so when this is 150, we are going to destroy Pikachu. We should probably hide these counters now. We don't need them. Ouch. Let's go find a battle. There's our first battle. Fight. Fight again, and it looks like I'm going to win. Yeah, Pikachu wins. Let's walk around and see if we can find another battle. Whoa, we found another battle. Whoa, Pikachu's health is really bad. Can we win this? Whoa, that was very close. We better head back to the town to recharge Pikachu. Alright, so you can see that this is extremely simple. There's nothing to it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, give it a thumbs down. Alright, so that's it for this video. I'm going to post an update later. Don't forget to check out my other channel, the Sparkman Vlog. Follow me on Twitter, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.